Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss the questions from the subject strength of materials which were asked in MES 2019. Question number 1. The shear force and bending moment are zero at the free end of a cantilever beam if it carries a first point load at the free end, point load at the middle of its length, uniformly distributed load over the whole length and none of the above. Now, as far as first three points are considered, I have drawn the figures for all these three cases. In the first case, a cantilever is shown, a load is shown at the free end. Second case, load is acting at the midpoint of this cantilever beam and a cantilever is subjected to an UDL over its entire length. SFD for all these three cases is as shown. Here it will be a straight line, here also a straight line, there it will be an inclined line. Then again an inclined line over here, inclined line over here, and a parabola over here. So they have said that the shear force and bending moment are zero. We can see that shear force is zero over here, zero over here, zero over here. So shear force is zero at the free end. Bending moment is also zero at the free end. And in all these three cases, shear force and bending moment is zero. And that is why the given question is wrong. And in the answer key for this question, MPSC has given a hash. Means no option is matching to this question. So the question was wrong. Question number 2. A steel rod of cross-sectional area 100 mm square and 1 meter long is subjected to a tensile force of 40 kN. What is the total elongation of the rod if modulus of elasticity of steel is 200 GPa? Now here in this question, the terms which are given are area A is equal to 100 mm square. The length is given as 1 meter, which can be converted into mm as 1000 mm. P is equal to 40 kN, so which is 40 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. E is given as 200 GPa. So which can be converted as 200 into 10 raised to 3 newtons per mm square, and it is asked to get the change in length. Now we know the basic formula for change in length, delta L is equal to PL upon AE. P is 40 into 10 raised to 3 newton into L is 1000, A is 100 and E is 200 into 10 raised to 3. So the answer will be 10 raised to 3 gets cancelled out with this 10 raised to 3, 100 is getting cancelled out. So it is 40 into 10, 400 divided by 200, which is 2 mm, and that is why option 4 is the correct option. Next question. A simply supported beam carries couple at a point on its span, the shear force, and the four options are given. Now I have considered a simply supported beam. Now let a moment, which is an anti-clockwise moment, M is acting at this point. Now if anti-clockwise movement is acting on a beam, it is obvious that the reactions will form a clockwise moment. So in order to balance this anti-clockwise movement. So that is why the reaction at B will be acting downwards, whereas reaction at A, it will be acting upwards. And this is how the clockwise moment will be produced, which will balance the applied moment. Now if shear force diagram for this beam is drawn, it will be like this. And which means that the shear force is uniform throughout. At every cross section, the shear force remains constant, and that is why the correct option is option number 4. Next question. Euler buckling load for one end fixed and the other hinged is given by. Now we know that for one end fixed and the other hinged, effective length L is equal to L by root 2. So effective length is given by the actual length divided by root 2. Whereas Euler's load, the formula is PE is equal to pi square EI upon effective length square. Now this effective length can be substituted as L by root 2. So L square will become L by root 2 square. Numerator is remaining as it is. So root 2 square, it will be 2. So this 2 will go to the numerator and the formula will be 2 pi square EI upon L square. Option 2 is the correct option. Next question. A point in a strained material is subjected to two mutually perpendicular stresses of 150 MPa tensile and 50 MPa compressive. Then what will be the magnitude of maximum shear stress in the component. Now here, in order to get the solution or the correct option, I am drawing the strained material. It is that strained material. Now sigma x is given as tensile, so I have shown sigma x as tensile, which is 150 MPa, whereas sigma y, it is compressive, which is 50 MPa. So I have shown the stress along y direction also. Now in order to get the maximum value of stress, shear stress, I am considering Mohr circle. Now let it be x axis and it has y axis. We know that the direct stress is to be plotted along x axis. The tensile stress, I am treating it as positive. So sigma x, I am plotting it to the right. So this value is sigma x. From the origin till this end, it is sigma x. Now sigma y will be on this side. So this is sigma y. Now sigma x is 150, sigma y is 50. So this total diameter will be 200 mm for this circle. So this Mohr circle can be drawn by considering the midpoint of this total length, which will be 100 mm on both sides. So consider 100 mm as a radius and draw a circle. So it is the Mohr circle for this given condition. Now maximum shear stress, or the shear stress, is to be measured along y axis. So tau max will be this radius. So this radius is nothing but 200 divided by 2, which is 100, and that is why the correct option for this question is 100 MPa. Option 2 is the correct one. Next question: Euler's formula for buckling of column does not hold good if slenderness ratio is. Now we know that slenderness ratio is the ratio of effective length to the least radius of gyration. So Le by K. Euler's formula is applicable only to long columns, and it is not applicable to the short columns. And a column is called as short column if Le by K is less than 80, and that is why Euler's formula is not applicable to the short column, means when the slenderness ratio is less than 80. So option 1 is the correct option. Next question: maximum deflection of a simply supported beam with the total uniformly distributed load W is. Now it is a standard formula which is well known to us. The maximum deflection in case of a simply supported beam carrying an UDL over its entire span is given by 5 by 384 WL cube upon EI. Next question: if a prismatic bar of uniform cross section A and length L is suspended from top, then the elongation of the bar due to its self weight only is. Now E is given as modulus of elasticity, and gamma is the density of the bar. Now when a bar is suspended like this, let the length of the bar is L and cross sectional area is A, then the deformation of this bar due to its self weight is given as delta L is equal to, or change in length is given as delta L is equal to WL divided by 2AE. But again, this W is in nothing but the specific mass into cross-sectional area into length, means specific mass into the volume. So if I substitute W over here in this formula, it will become gamma AL square divided by 2AE. So A will get cancelled out, and the final relation will be delta L is equal to gamma L square divided by 2E. Option 1 is the correct option. Next question: the relation governing the simple bending of beam is. Now we know that the equation of bending is given by sigma bending divided by y is equal to m upon I is equal to E upon R, and that is why the correct option is option number 4. Next question: a steel bar of 5 mm is heated from 15 degree to 40 degree centigrade and it is free to expand. The bar will induce. Now it is a question which is related to temperature stresses. We know that whenever any material is heated, it expands. Whereas if the temperature of that material is decreased, it contracts. However, if this expansion or contraction takes place freely, no stresses are induced inside the material. If the expansion is prevented, compressive stresses are induced. If contraction is prevented, tensile stresses are induced. But if the member is free to expand, no stresses are induced, and that is why the correct option is option 1. Question: A simply supported beam AB of span 10 meter carries a point load W is equal to 10 kN at C such that AC is 3 meter and BC is 7 meter. And the question is asked regarding the maximum deflection. Now it is a similar question which was asked in MES 2018. Now AC and BC, there are these two subspans. Now it is obvious that the maximum deflection is going to appear in between B and C. Option 4 is the correct option.